Hello there and welcome. This is going to be introducing new players, three simple chords on the very beginnings of how to play acoustic blues. So without further ado, let me tune up E string, but it's actually E flat. Most of the time I play a semitone down, but don't worry about that, just tune into this. A string. D string. String. Now if we play an E chord, now all my videos are recorded live, so if there's any mistakes in them, they stay in, because I like to show players that even pros make mistakes, and I don't like all the slick editing. We're all human. Here we go. What we're going to learn to do is take a straightforward E7 chord. You'll see it like that in a book. Little finger on there. Then we'll be using a straightforward A7 chord. Then for the turnaround, we'll be using a B7 chord. Which is that finger there, that one there, and that one there. This little finger on the bottom in the first fret, second fret, sorry. That's what we're going to learn to do. This is your first tentative steps into getting a mellow, nice blues sound. So close up now, let's just take one look. There, there, there. This can go on the third fret on the B string. A couple of ways we can play this. We can remove this finger. Opens it up a bit more. We can do a shortened version, which is just those two. But for the purpose of what we're playing, play it as a full chord like that. Okay. The A chord. Using that finger. Sometimes, if I'm going to do something longer, I use that finger. When I'm lazy and I'm coming off a chord, I sometimes just put my little finger there. For the B7 chord, what I do sometimes with the B7 chord is let my finger rest against that E string, so I use it as a beat. So you get that sound sometimes, like that. But let's just stay straight. going to be our first move. Trust me, if you follow this, you're going to sound groovy. Thumb, first finger, second finger. So that's the first finger, that's the second. So all we want to do first is get used to that. Play the A7 chord. Now I will say at this point, let's go back to the E7. Sometimes my thumb goes between those two strings. But I might do it very lightly like this. Sometimes I might do them together. Thumb, finger, finger. A7. Back to E7. B7. A7. Stop on the E. Later on, I'll show you how to do that. So let's just get this in a bit more. I'm trying to get this just the right place so you get a real good look at those fingers going on there. Now you can make it do this. See the different ways? Together, then the bottom two. We can pick through like this. Let's have a look how I did that little bit there then. Just touching that. I can pull that off like this. That means you pluck the strings. Just pull your finger away. Let's have a look at that with the other hand. Going at a very slow, mellow pace here. We're just going to get, this is your first chance to get onto it. Thank you. let's have a look at picking it. See how we're hitting. Do a slightly heavier pick. String, bottom two, G string, bottom two. I just put that little feel. Let's just go back on that. Add that little finger at the third fret again. I'll show you what I'm going to do now. I'm going to start moving it slightly now. So we're going to go from here. And then the bottom string open. Let's try that. And note the way I'm not making much of this note here, because we just want to just taking my finger off. Now let's have a look at bringing some of those little moves into to make it more cooler. move from this fourth fret, A string open, first fret into the chord, the B7. Try that. How mellow it's going, just show you that little A piece there. Second, third, one more time. We could go. I think this one works nice and mellow. I'll play it one time with those little bits in and then we'll go back to the other hand. So with the moves again. As you can see, I'm throwing little picks in, but you've got to work it out that it's just the feel, the mood, you know. of my turn again. See where I start to put and feel on it? See what you can achieve when you start getting into it? What I did there was hit a harder. Well, let's have a look how I did that. What I'm using, palm of my hand, is on the strings. See the palm? Killing the string. See what happens when I lift my palm? Back down. That's open. Third fret on the B string, with your other finger. Open. Let's take a look at that. I'm trying little bends here now. See the little thing go? Now you may hear a train or a lot of you. There's nothing I can do about it. See that? What I'm doing here is choking it. When I'm on there, then show what I'm getting, I feel there. Now sometimes for power I hit this string with this finger, sometimes I do it with that one. See the different ways? I'm going to try and just play this a little bit. bit more picking. Now I'm going to show you. But first, we just pick up on that one more time. Using to do that is this E7 chord. That's the way you'd see it in a book. But we just want these three played with those three fingers. So in effect, it's a D7 chord, D sharp 7, or E flat 7. E7. We'll remove the finger off the bottom, so we've got these two. And just slide back, and just clip that, hit the bottom string open, then A string, B flat note, B, 7. Got a bit technical there with all the B flats and all that. I don't normally do that because I don't know a lot of what it means. So here we go, one more go. Let's have a look at that little turnaround point there. Let's really thin it out so it's really thin now. Now this is just for practicing purpose, this. Thank you. bit up there. Last time touching on that bit there, remember there's loads of different ways of hitting it. It's whatever you feel you're at. We've made it a lot more heavier there towards the end, so I'm ready with the seventh and I go, bend it slightly, let go, hit the bottom string, put my finger on the bottom string, finger goes on the bottom string as well. Drop it on the guitar. It's the weight you want. You can hit that as many times as you like, really. Remember, recapping from the start. We had it. We'll just stay on the E chord here, just so I can show you the different ways how we've been hitting it. That one's if you want to have a go trying to pick it slightly quicker. Remember, it's just that chord going. What that's doing is taking it slightly into a more delta sound. So we're on the E7 and we pluck those two strings. Bring your little finger down. So we're that moved into position on the G. See the relationship? All we're doing there is playing an E7 chord. Watch this hand here, the way it's hitting the strings. What I do is a squeeze, let go of the pressure. I hope you thought that was helpful, because I do. I think that is the way to be learning acoustic blues. Now, if you donate and get this video, and you're just beginning, I really think you'll have got something that you can refer back to and look on to the future. If you want to be an acoustic blues player, you want to get the right kind of feel, I say this without conviction, you follow what I do and I'll show you the best way. No bullshit, no telling you can do this when you can't. This is the way to learn, just one-to-one doing it like this, and I hope that it helped you. That's the first one. When I do another one, I'll just continue that. And if you decide to collect them and help, and you'll be helping me out as well, you'll end up with a really good library of blues tips. So I hope that was, I hope I enjoyed making it. And if you do get it, let me know what you think. Remember, it does have its little mistakes in it. I do things slightly differently, but I'm a real player, that's what we do. Best of luck, and thanks for buying.